Welcome all, this is Devi Shri and you can start your IBPS AFO preparation with www.agriguru.in. And today we are going to discuss the topic on components of IPM, which stands for Integrated Pest Management. It is nothing but we are integrating all the pest management strategies to control the pest infestation. And the National Center for Integrated Pest Management is located at New Delhi. Under this, we are going to see the cultural practices, mechanical practices, genetic practices, regulatory practices, biological practices, chemical practices. That is, combination of all these practices means integrated pest management strategies. First is cultural practices. It consists of regular farm operations in such a way which either destroy the pests or prevent them from causing economic loss. The various cultural practices have been grouped as follows. First is preparation of nurseries or main field by removing the plant debris, trimming of bunds, treating of soil and deep summer. This means that doing all these strategies reduces the pest infestation and breaks the pest life cycle. Second is ploughing. 3. Proper drainage system. 4. Testing the soil for nutrient deficiencies on the basis of which fertilizer should be applied. Selection of clean and certified seeds. Seed treatment, selection of seeds with resistant or tolerant varieties, adjustment of time of sowing and harvesting to escape peak season of pest attack, rotation of crops with non-host crops. It helps in reduction of incidence of soil-borne diseases, proper plant spacing which makes plant healthier and less susceptible to pests, optimum use of fertilizer, use of farmyard manure and biofertilizer should be encouraged. Proper water management, alternate wetting and drying to avoid water stagnation. Proper weed management, weed can also act as a host for the pests. Setting up yellow pan sticky traps for sucking pests such as whiteflies and aphids at far above the canopy height. Synchronized sowing, which is a community approach. A community of the farmers should sow at the same time so that if pest appears in damaging proportion, control operation could also be applied effectively in whole area. Growing trap crops on the borders or peripheries of fields. There are certain crops which are preferred more by a pest species. These are known as trap crops of that pest. Root dip or seedling treatment in pest infested area. Intercropping or multiple cropping. All the crops are not preferred by each pest species and certain crops act as a repellent, which in turn reduces the pest incidence. Harvesting as close as to ground level. This makes the breakage of life cycle of pests. Before planting, nursery plants could be sprayed or dipped in proper fungicide or biopesticide solution to protect the plants from soil-borne diseases. While pruning fruit trees, remove crowded or dead or broken or diseased branches and destroy them. We should not pile them in the orchards, which will act as a source of pest infestation. Large pruning wounds should be covered with Bordeaux paste or paint to protect the plants from pest or disease attack. For excellent fruit set, pollinizer cultivars should be planted in required proportion in the orchards. For this, keeping beehives or placing flower bouquets of pollinizer cultivars facilitate better pollination and subsequent fruit set. Next is mechanical practices. Under mechanical practices, removal and destruction of egg masses, larvae, pupa, and adults of insect pests and diseased parts of plants wherever possible. Installation of bamboo cage cum bird perches in the field and placing parasitized egg masses inside them for conservation of natural enemies. Withholding the pest species wherever possible. Use of light traps and destruction of trapped insects. Use of rope for dislodging leaf feeding larvae, example case worm and leaf folders. Installation of bird scatter in the field where required. Installation of bird perches in the field for allowing birds to sit and feed on insects and their immature stages such as egg, larva and pupa. Use of pheromones for mating disruption, monitoring pest levels and mass trapping. Next is genetic practices. Under this, selection of comparatively pest resistant or tolerant varieties with reasonable yield levels is one of the best genetic practices that that is used to control the pest. Regulatory practices. Regulatory rules framed by government or brought into force, which is nothing but quarantine methods, under which seeds and infested plant materials are not allowed to enter the country or from one part to the other parts of the country. These are known as quarantine methods, and it is of two types, domestic and foreign quarantine. Domestic is within the country or within the state, and foreign is between the country or between the states. Biological practices, it is a most important component of integrated pest management. In broader sense, biocontrol is use of living organisms to manage crop damaging life living organism, that is pests. Some of the common biocontrol agents are parasitoids, parasites, etc. Parasitoids, these are the organisms which lay eggs in or on the bodies of their hosts and complete their life cycles on host bodies. As a result, the host dies. The parasitoid may be of different type depending on the host developmental stage in or which in completes its life cycle. For example, egg parasitoid, larval parasitoid, pupal parasitoid, adult parasitoid, egg larval parasitoid, larval pupal parasitoid, etc. In case of egg larval parasitoid, the parasitoid stays on the egg and also in the larva. In case of larval pupal, it stays on the larval and as well as in the pupal stage of the pest. The example for this are Trichogramma, Aphantelus, Brachon, Chelonis, Brachymeria, Pseudogonotopus, etc. Predators, these are free living organisms which prey upon the organisms for their food. For example, different species of spiders, dragonfly, damselfly, ladybird beetles, Chrysopus species, birds, etc. Next is pathogens. These are microorganisms which infest and cause disease in their host, as a result of which hosts are killed. Major groups of pathogens are fungi, viruses, bacteria. Some nematodes can also cause disease in some insect pests. For example, in case of fungi, different species of Isutella, Bivaria, Nomuria, Metarhizium. In case of viruses, it is like nuclear polyhedrosis virus and granulosis virus. In case of bacteria, it is BT, Bacillus thuringiensis and Bacillus populi. This Bacillus thuringiensis is most widely used in cotton to control pink bollworm. Biocontrol practices. Disease-causing agents of pests can be mass-multiplied in the laboratory at a low cost in liquid or powdered formulations. And this formulation is called as biopesticides. And these biopesticides can be sprayed like ordinary chemical pesticides. The different types of biocontrol practices are grouped as under. One is introduction. Introduction is nothing but a new species of bioagent is introduced into a locality for its establishment against its host. This is done only after through laboratory examination and field trials for its efficacy. Next is augmentation. In this process, the population of natural enemies already present in the area is increased. This is done by releasing their laboratory, raid or field collected bioagents. The released bioagents are of same species in such number as would require to suppress the pest population in that area. Third is conservation. It is a most important component of biological control and it also plays a major role in pest suppression. In this process, natural enemies present in the nature are protected from being killed. The different practices required to protect the natural enemies, and these are mentioned below. One is collection of parasitized egg masses and placing them in a bamboo cage cum bird perches following emergence of parasitoids and withholding the pest larvae. Awareness to differentiate pest and defenders and sparing the defenders during the field sprays. Chemical spray should be adopted at last resort and that too after observing pest defender ratio and economic threshold level. Use of broad spectrum pesticides should be avoided. Only selective and relatively environment friendly pesticides should be used wherever necessary. As far as possible, strip of spot application of pesticide is to be carried out. Adjustment of time of sowing and harvesting to avoid the peak season of pest attack. Growing trap crop on the borders of the main fields before the actual sowing of crop to trap pest and develop natural enemies. Root dip or seedling treatment for gall midge prone area. Crop rotation and intercropping also help in the conservation of defenders. If pesticides are used, only recommended dose and concentration is to be used. Last is chemical practices. Use of chemical pesticides is the last resort when all other methods fail to keep the pest population below economic loss. Use of pesticides should be need-based, judicious, based on pest survivance and economic threshold level. This helps to minimize not only the cost involved but also to reduce the associated problems. While going for chemical control, we must understand thoroughly what to spray, when to spray, where to spray, how to spray, and keeping in mind the following points. The ETL and pest defender ratio must be observed. Relatively safer pesticides should be selected, example neem-based and biopesticides. If pest is present in strips or isolated patches, whole field should not be sprayed. Relevance of integrated pest management practices is more important in vegetable and fruit crops because of their unique mode of consumption by human being. Pesticides which are generally highly toxic or known to have toxic residual effects should not be recommended offhand. To get more profit, farmers do not wait until waiting periods of pesticides and harvest the crop to market the same. This leads to pesticide poisoning, chronic effects, and sometimes may cause death. Thus, we have to be more careful and cautious in applying pest control practices in the field crops. Thank you. You can start your IBPS AFO preparation with www.agriguru.in, and the PDFs are available in the AgriLearner application, and the link for the application is provided in the description.